Now we will see how to pass an array to a function. This is as same as that of sending one variable to a function, but here little bit difference is there in a syntax. Just we will go for that. So here while sending array to the function without subscript, we'll just write the array name, and while receiving we'll write the subscript, but will not mention any value inside the scripts. So that is nothing but inside a square bracket will not mention anything while receiving it. That is in a function declaration and in a function definition part. Just we'll see the syntax now. So here so remaining syntax will remain same. So just difference is if you observed first parameter that we are sending as a ARR underscore name square bracket open square bracket close in function declaration part. So here this is nothing but we are saying as a one array will be sent to the function, and after that second one we are sending the size of that array. So here so while declaring the array, so we may declare 1000 or 10,000 like that any number of elements, but in that will all elements will not be valid for us. So whichever valid elements are there, those we will send it to perform the operation. Okay, we'll take one example for that. And in main, if you observed while calling function, that is fun underscore name open bucket, just we are giving the array name along with size, that is a valid size we want to perform some operation in the array elements. We'll take one example here. Our intention of this program is to display the values which we received from the user. Okay, so inside main we will be getting the values from the user, and we'll call one function called as a display. So inside display function we are just printing the values of those values we are printing whichever we received from the user. So here inside main first we are declaring the array a of 100. So here maximum size of array I have given as a 100, so user can enter up to 100 element values. Now we'll ask user how many number of elements he want to enter. So that is we are receiving in n variable. So whatever value he will give, so those many elements will receive from the user again. So that is suppose he given n value as a 5, so we are going to ask him to enter 5 elements. So here in a for loop, so we are receiving 5 elements. So those 5 elements whatever are there, whatever we stored in array, so that we are sending it to the display function. So how we are sending is just we are calling the function name, that is display open bracket array name, just name of the array will be given, that is a comma size n, that is what number of elements whatever we received from the user. Here in this case we took as a 5, so that will be sent. So in function definition it will receive it, that is array a it will receive it, and n value as a 5 it will receive it, and inside a for loop it's printing the values. So all 5 elements will be printed here. So like this we can send array elements to the function, that is always name of the array in square bracket, we will not mention anything, comma, then size of the element will take it. So now we'll see how to send a string to a function. So string is nothing but again it's a kind of array only, but data type is character. So there is nothing but collection of characters. Just difference is here data type will be character. So here while sending we are giving the function name open bucket string name, we are not sending any size. Why? Because string always ends with slash zero. So in a function whatever operation we are performing, we know where to stop it. So always while sending the strings we will not send the size, because in a string always string will be ended with slash 0. So we'll take one example. So here in this example, we're asking user to enter one string, so that we're receiving in str variable here. Then we're sending that string to the display function. So in display function, we're receiving it, and whatever value is there, just we're printing it. So here if you observed, so we don't have any size parameter, which was there in previous example. So whenever we are sending numericals, that time we require the size. So whenever you are sending the string, we don't require the size, because we know where to stop it. That is, whenever in a string slash 0 occurs, it will stop automatically.